This May marks 5 years since I started this channel to document building an electric car. The car still doesn't exist. The channel? Chugging along just fine. Recently, a bunch of new subscribers showed up and most of you have no idea what was this supposed to be about. So to celebrate 5 years of not finishing what I started, I'm doing what I do best, making another video that isn't about building an electric car. This one is about why there isn't one yet. This whole thing kicks way before YouTube even existed. And for some reason, probably because the universe enjoys mocking me, this memory is stored in my brain with perfect clarity. So, it's the year 2004. Facebook just launched at Harvard. George W. Bush wins re-election. And Janet Jackson's wardrobe malfunction somehow becomes the most important news story of the year. I'm working as an engineer at electron microscopy company, installing and servicing X-ray spectrometers, which is exactly as thrilling as it sounds. I am on the plane back from Italy, reading some news magazine when I see this article about some playboy millionaire who is planning to build an electric sports car. His genius plan? Stuff it full of laptop batteries and bolt on an electric motor to it. And I remember thinking, what a complete nut job. Because everyone knew laptop batteries were garbage that died after 500 charge cycles. And who is going to drop six figures on a sports car that sounds like a vacuum cleaner instead of a proper V8? Turns out I was completely wrong.
Fast forward a few years, my wife gave me a birthday present. One day test drive of Tesla Model S, which had just started selling in the UK. I get in, I press the accelerator, and it feels like a car is hardwired directly into your brain. Zero lag, just pure instant acceleration. I was completely sold on technology, but not on price. So naturally, I did what any other reasonable person would do. I started a YouTube channel. Not really. The name, Latuto EV, the plan is to document building my own electric car and making educational videos about motors, batteries, and all that good stuff. That's where I discovered Open Inverter Project, specifically Johannes Hubner and Damien Maguire. I went to first fully charged event at Silverstone and saw Damien's EV converted BMW, I believe it was nicknamed Super Yacht.
Hello folks, and welcome to Fully Charged Live 2019. We're on day two. But I'm going to give you guys a bit of a walk around here and you can see some of the cars.
And I thought, I can do this. I wanted to start with something practical, something manageable. So I went with a Prius Gen 3 inverter, one of the more affordable options that would not require a second mortgage. I added a gearbox later, which happens to be two electric motors combined in one unit. Those two motors are called MG1 and MG2, which basically means motor generator 1 and 2. Here you go, points for Toyota for consistency. The system uses a planetary gearset along with a series of gears to transmit power to the wheels. Damien's idea was to weld the planetary gearset solid, effectively locking both motors together so they could dump combined output straight to the drivetrain. But before any of that could happen, step one was to replace Toyota factory control board with open inverter PCB. And because I don't do things the easy way, I decided to make my own PCB from scratch using Damien's design file. I ordered board from JLC PCB, sourced components from Farnell, GGK, AliExpress, basically everywhere would ship to me. This was 2020, by the way. You know that year, which had 19 in the name, where absolutely nothing went wrong with the global supply chain. But before I could even worry about PCBs, I had to crack open inverter, which I did, not without breaking several things in the process. I'm not an expert by any means. Electronics are supposed to be my strong suit, but I still manage to waste hours chasing down problems I'd created myself. Faulty oscilloscope probe, check. Forgetting to screw in three-phase motor connections, also check. Hence the videos about wrestling with a parking pole, throttle control contactors, all resulting in more grey hairs than actual subscribers. Eventually, I got motor to spin. Victory, right? Well, in the process, I also managed to damage DC to DC converter while was opening the inverter. I spent even more time trying to fix it and ultimately gave up. This particular nut remained uncracked until the last year. Here's one problem. You really need batteries to run electric motor. And the only batteries I could afford at the time, laptop batteries.
Used ones, from discarded packs from recycling centers. Yeah, those batteries. The idea came from Jehu Garcia on YouTube.
All right, let's talk about batteries.
Who's been pulling apart laptop packs and proving they weren't completely dead, just mostly dead. Here's the thing about laptop batteries. Typically, one cell goes bad and triggers the protection circuit. That breaks entire pack. But the other cells? Still perfectly fine. Sometimes they got 80-90% capacity left. So I started collecting dead laptop batteries, cracking them open and testing individual cells. Then sorting them by capacity. Then grouping them into match sets. It became its own project. A tedious, time-consuming project. But wait, there is more. Because you can't just wire up a giant pile of lithium cells and call it a day. You need a battery management system, a BMS, to keep them balanced, monitored, and ideally not on fire. And because I'm apparently incapable of doing things the easy way, I didn't buy one, I decided to build my own. I went with the DIY BMS design, made the PCBs, sourced the components, soldered everything together, got it working. Great success.
God knows how long this Prius experiment would have dragged on if I hadn't stumbled across a Tesla motor on eBay. From Lithuania, of all places. It was rather cheap. Maybe it was the second glass of red wine. Maybe it was a temporary insanity. Either way, I bought it. Now, by this point, I knew Damien had an open inverter design for the Tesla Model S and X small drive units. So, obviously, the next logical step was to grab the design files from his GitHub, upload them to JLCPCB, and order the board. Some components were not available through JLC assembly service, so I ordered those separately. Board arrives, I run some basic tests, solder the missing bits, and set up a bench test. The bench test went fine, smooth, which was almost disappointing. The real fun started when I tried removing the Tesla factory board from the motor itself. See, those sensors were soldered in the control board and ported inside the motor housing, right next to three-phase voltage cables to sense the current, of course. And while extracting them, I damaged the sensors. Completely stuck, no idea what to do. And then help arrived from unexpected source. Damien Maguire himself showed up in YouTube comments with the part number for the replacement sensors. And then another viewer chimed in with sourcing advice since I couldn't find them on Mauser. Crisis resolved, new sensors arrived, I got soldered them into the board. And actually, after a few more revelations, the motor has spun, pun intended. Now at this point, any normal person would have mounted motor in the car and started testing. Well, instead I went on a months-long tangent designing my own board variant of the Tesla Open Inverter board. Because why finish one project when you can start another? You can watch the whole saga in the video linked in the corner.
After you finish this video.
So here we are, year 2025 has ended. 5 years in, still no electric car. But I'm looking at 2026 with what I can only describe as cautious optimism. I've got Tesla motor that actually spins, I've got custom boards that work, and I've got just enough stubbornness to see this through. So if you want to see whether I can actually finish something or just watch me find new ways of creatively distracting myself, hit subscribe. Either way, it should be entertaining. See you this year in 2026. The year of electric car? Probably. Maybe.